And starting the game. So, Battlefield of Eternity. Do it right versus Admiral Ackbar. Do it right doing the first pick, first ban, meaning Admiral Ackbar did pick the map. Oh, I didn't link the stream. Feels bad, man. People that I find strong on this map are Tanis. Amateur opponent allows you to really nuke the Immortal down pretty quick. Greymane's also strong if you pair him with, you know, if you're able to keep him alive and allow him to actually swipe on the Immortals. The only thing is that a lot of times you're not usually able to have a melee hero stay on the Immortal because you're either defending or pushing into a defensive position or pushing into the other team defending, and your melee heroes don't get too much value there. And that's what gets Li Ming a lot of value, because her range on her abilities is ridiculously far. It really allows them to, you know, if they're defending yours, like where your safe position, then Li Ming can always poke from safety. If you're pushing into the attack and they're defending, then Li Ming can poke from safety. So, but Do It Right decides to ban ETC. There are a lot of, what's it called? Like, funnel points on this map when you're fighting on the Immortals. My Chielli team this week definitely lost to an ETC on this map this week. So I can see the pain there from Do It Right deciding to ban the ETC. And we'll see if Admiral Ackbar decides to ban Artanis. I think Artanis is very strong on this map. Like I said before, it's pretty easy to get swaps because everybody's just kind of huddling around the Immortal all the time, whether you're attacking or they're defending. And they decide to ban Ragnaros. So this does leave a lot of options open. You can take the Li Ming first, or you can take Malfurion first, because you want the healer. Or you can take Artanis, or you can take... And they decide to pick none of those and go with Vala. I mean, that's pretty interesting. I mean, Vala's also another big racer on the map. She has the Hungarian Arrow build. And the first pick, Lucio Diablo. Not one I've seen a lot on this map. Especially the Diablo pick. I mean, I'm not... Like, there's so many options if you really want... I guess they're focusing more on their team fighting potential versus their race potential right off the bat, thinking that they probably have a lot of options left open to race if they want to. The Lucio pick over the Malfurion. So I think Lucio is... People are starting to realize that Lucio is stronger than Malfurion, but Malfurion just provides so much, you know, kill potential and utility to the team that... Yeah, that's why a lot of people are still picking him up. And then, but like the Diablo pick is, I like, it's interesting to me. There's a lot of points to charge into somebody into something, and that allows you to. Oh, sorry, I had a sneeze there. And so that does allow you to get some stuns, but I feel like you're not really in a position where you can normally charge into people. But we'll have to see how it plays out. You know, you have the Diablo. Charge, flip, Lucio boop backwards. That can get somebody really out of position. And while I've been talking during all that, Do It Right does pick up the Artanis and the Varian. So we do have the double front line. Artanis allows you to race, Vala allows you to race, Varian allows you to follow up on any Artanis swaps. You can get the instant stun lock. Looking pretty scary so far. And with the Varian pickup, it's also strong because the Lucio actually does not have any cleanse. So once Varian does get 10, Lucio's only ability to stop it is, or to stop a lot of damage coming through, is his ultimate, which is on like an 80 second something cooldown, which is usually a win for the Varian team. But, you know, if you don't have a lot of follow-up damage, it's not that big of a deal. I mean, Varian can do a lot of damage by himself regardless, but... They do ban Sylvanas. I think they're looking at their team right now saying, hey, we will most likely lose some of the races. And if they do have Sylvanas while they win the race, it could spell disaster. So we don't want to deal with that. Ban out the Sylvanas. I mean, Sylvanas is strong on any map where the objective has a monster or a something, a vehicle that pushes with you, is like with your five-man team, is what makes Sylvanas so strong. Like, you don't see her a lot on Dragonshire because the vehicle takes away one of your team members, so you're still fighting a 4v5, and then the Sylvanas loses value there because there's not a fifth person to defend or to push with. But on maps like Infernal Shrines, Battlefield of Eternity, That's where you're going to get a lot of value out of Sylvanas. Knowing that they have two tanks, Do It Right decides to ban Tychus. Plus, any type of follow-up damage, Tychus does add a lot of, like, almost burst, but still sustained damage to a team. Admiral Ackbar picking Joanna Falstad. I would not have guessed Joanna after already picking the Diablo. I don't really know. I mean, we'll have to see how this plays out. I'm not really sure what they're going for here. So far, they completely lose any type of race. So that tells me that they're going to be completely looking to defend and potentially having somebody killing their own or soaking. I like the monk pick, but I Do It Right. And the hammer. Okay, so there's their defense and the race potential. It's very interesting. So they have the peel with the Diablo and the Joanna. They have the damage from the back line with the hammer. But in the early game, it still doesn't allow them to win the race. So their goal is still going to be to defend. And now with the defense, they have hammer just sit on the point. And then they'll be able to just defense, like, peel for with Joanna Diablo, and we'll have to see how it plays out. They don't have too much poke. Thanks for the host, new type. After I called you out on your drink, I actually don't usually carry drinks with me while I'm casting, because, man, props to you. Maybe I'll try. I actually had a couple beers earlier today, some good wheats. But yeah, so I mean, with their plan here is going to be have hammer defend with the Joanna, Diablo, Lucio. That gives you plenty of peel for hammer, and they'll possibly have Falstad attack the immortal on their own or the other team's immortal. So I like it. I mean, I like the idea of it, but the only problem here is that Do It Right has Artanis, so we'll have to watch those swaps. But Battlefield of Eternity, on the left side, we have Do It Right. We got Iceman on the Vala, Ronin on the Varian, Lady Ronin on the Brightwing, Hannibal on the Monk, and Tantrum on the Artanis. On the right side, Admiral Ackbar, Hidalgo on the Falstad, Danger Sock on the Joanna, Shubadoop on the Hammer, Hypo Crazy on the Lucio, and Iron Bank on the Diablo. Right off the bat, we're seeing a five-man push. Look in the top lane. They do have the Falstad, so they are able to push with a five-man right off the bat. And then they can just have Falstad fly bottom whenever they get finished with the push. Whenever they get defended, they'll just, you know, back off a little bit. Falstad fly bottom. He won't miss any soak. It'll be okay. They do see the whole team here, so we're going to see the rotation. And this is going to force the first engagement. Joanna is looking for a little bit of the peel. Having Artanis go first. See if they can get any swaps. They do have Lucio can boot for any swaps. One swap does go down, immediately followed up by the sheep. And if we see that all day, then Hammer's going to have a tough time. Any type of sieging position is allowing Artanis to just, you know, he'll just be like a free target for Artanis. And so with that, we're going to want to see the Lucio. As I said, Falstaff flies down here. Probably only missed like once, one minion. But we're going to want to see the Lucio time his boop. Honestly, I have no idea what it's called. I don't even see Lucio that often. His boop with the Artanis interrupt, and that's another great swap. Unfortunately, the team wasn't able to follow up with it. They weren't quite in the right position. They were all still in the mid lane, but Artanis is looking to be trying to walk back to his team outside of the hammer. See, there you go. Lucio had the right idea there. I don't know if you saw that. It was pretty quick, but as soon as the Artanis swapped in, Lucio used his sound wave. That's the ability. Sound wave to try to interrupt him and especially push him into the towers, and that would have spelled disaster for Artanis. So that's what Lucio's plan for this game is right now. So he needs the rest of the team to rotate down here if they're going to try to do any type of swap. But first immortals are spawning, and we're going to see how this plays out. If the hammer team gets better position, which they do, favorable for blue, and they're just going to sit here, get easy free hits, great positioning on this hammer. But yes, Do It Right does have easy racing potential, And there was not quite enough peel. And now with the Immortal spawning over here, I'd like to see the two tanks get really aggressive here. The position that the hammer is in, he doesn't have to move. And any time that the blue team does push into this a little bit, granted, they're not quite in range of the hammer. Double stun on the Vala and the Brightwing, allowing them to push in the back a little bit. And their Tannis getting swapped, and this is going to spell doom for him. Actually, never mind the swap rotation. Allow to pick off the Lucio, but the Immortal decides to kill off our Tannis, and Diablo goes down as well. A 2-for-1 trade, and still having the Vala and the Monk being able to race. And a first Immortal going to do it right. Maybe? Do they need to finish it off? What's happening right here? Okay, they all peeled off to go after the Joanna. They almost lost that Immortal, and that would have been silly. But still, Hammer, a great defender if they lose the Immortal. I think with that play, they're probably going to have to reevaluate how they want to do this. Either have Hammer in a different position where he's able to actually push the, attack the members of Do It Right when they're attacking the Immortal. In that position that he was in before, he was only able to attack his own attack the own Immortal, and not actually able to follow up on any disables of the Diablo or the Joanna. And I think with that, the right idea's there, but since they lost so hard on the racing potential, that they're not going to be able to really do what they plan to do. Like, their plan now is to have Hammer in a position between both of them, so that way if they retreat to Hammer, they can, but have Lucio, Diablo, and Joanna just disrupt the other team as much as possible. Artanis was looking for a little bit of a swap there, but with this four-man push top lane, I mean, they're still trying to get a lot of structure value. Knowing that they lost the Immortal, they're saying like, hey, we don't care, we'll just push anyways. And Artanis is gonna have to constantly be on the same lane as the Hammer to put the pressure on his positioning and the rest of the team. Varian's looking for no swap. The swap's a little bit far away. I guess they're trying to go for one of the tanks. But they do have the Varian stun and the Brightwing Sheep now. So even with the Diablo and the Lucio, they're really going to have to time their peels to keep the Hammer safe. We actually see auto attack build coming out from the Vala. Like I said, we said auto mature opponent and damn it, Iron Fist Monk for the race potential. And double heals. Double heals against a Hammer team. Double heals against a Hammer team and a double tank team. It's going to make Do It Right very sustainable, and they allow them to actually push into the Hammer a lot. Vala's actually there's a little risk to attack like that. I mean, she got away with it, but she actually did not know where the Hammer and the Falstead were. I mean, she assumed that they were taking the Giants, and the Knights, and that's why she could do that. But if any situation, that Falstead could have flown down there and killed that Vala and would have given them a big lead. The Monk is actually going for Air Ally for the for the voids. Lucio looking to get a little bit too far. So like right in the seat, we notice this position here. So Hammer's obviously doing this so that way he can still hit the Immortal and be in range of any time that the Do It Right push into this. But they're never going to push into this. They're actually always going to just sit on the outside lane. And Hammer's not going to get value there. And if they keep doing that, they will constantly lose the race. This is the position that helps the Hammer. But sitting out there for way too long, gets body blocked by Do It Right, and ends up going down between the stun and the Artanis Sheep. And now Admiral Ackbar is saying, well, crap, there goes our main carry. Joanna actually has no mana. She can't even use her ult, her trait, if she wants to, and she should be back in here, or at least tapping the well. Hammer just rezzed. She's on her way back, but with the stun on Diablo, could end up a kill. No swap available for a little bit of time. Once again, Artanis is actually really low on mana as well, but they actually kill this Immortal so quickly between Iron Fist, Vala, and Artanis. Don't even care about the Hammer. And they're just going to back away. A much more powerful Immortal this time around. And they actually almost got the keep because of those minions, those knights. If you let them alone, those knights will do so much work on a structure. I wonder why he got the reveal. Just wants the wards. I guess they could be looking for... It gives them vision for Artanis swaps. I could see that. All five members pushing for Do It Right. They want to get 10 right away, so that way they have the taunt from the Varian. The stun from the Varian actually allows the Immortal to follow up on the stun and gives them a quick kill on the Hammer. I mean, Hammer sat there for a while. She did not get the resistance at 1, so she kind of just took a lot of damage there. And the Immortal should die here pretty quickly, and they'll probably just rotate down and get this bottom fort, and which will give them level 10, and then they become really scary. There are 2 peels, and then also with the Lucio, 3 peels technically, but Falstad getting a little flying down aggressively, and the immediate stun and follow-up from the Varian and Monk. That Falstad was like, oh shoot, I flew and I can't do anything about it. And paid the price. So Admiral Ackbar needs to be looking for level 10 now. That's going to be their main priority. They kind of just have to play defense and just deal with the Merc pressure that's going to be happening soon. The next Immortal should be spawning in the next 40 seconds or so. We're going to look at that. 9-10-ish. Let's look at the talents. We do have Emerald Wind, Taunt, 7-Sided, Rain of Vengeance, and Purifier Beam. So once again, really focusing on the Hammer play. We don't need to pull... We'll force him out of position with the Purifier Beam. Once again, does end up Z-ing away, but leaving the Lucio by himself. And he ends up getting hit by the Varian combo. They actually didn't need to use any other alts. With the full team follow-up, he died pretty quick. And they're just gonna look to put on pressure. They don't have the healer. We actually see Hinterland's Blast. Very surprised by that, knowing that they're gonna have the engage constantly on the Hammer. I'm actually very surprised by the Hinterland's Blast. I'm assuming they think they need more damage. They can't rely on the 2 tanks and just the Hammer. Favorable position for Do It Right, since they do have the faster race, and they are able to rotate to it faster. Although, they're losing it because they don't have Artanis. It's going to be close. Looks like Do It Right barely gets the Immortal a little bit lower, only by 1,000 health. And this makes it a little bit more tricky. This is now favorable for Admiral Ackbar. Plus, they do have Mercs pushing. I think at this point, just have somebody run back, clear up the Mercs. You don't really need to push into this right away. They're not in any fear of losing the Immortal at this point. But with 2 ultimates going down, now they should be pretty okay with pushing into it. The Joanna is getting low, forcing the shield barrier from Lucio. Big Hinterland's Blast. I think that was a reset, full 5-man reset, getting the kill on the Vala. Looking for another position, but gets pushed away by the Emerald Wind. That would have been sick. Look at that. I mean, walking over here, getting greedy with a second reset. Joanna coming down. Oh, still getting low, still has the reset. Another... Holy cow! How much damage does he have now? With those 3 Hinterland's Blasts, really shot him up in damage. Oh, and he didn't get the second one, but those 2. And like I said, so during all that, they really did not want to push into this. They wanted to just let them defense, clear up their lanes, and then push when they have everybody back to heal. They weren't actually losing the Immortal, but man, Lucio just died instantly there. And now they're going to be able to push for days. Without any heals, big swap on their hammer. That was at max range, and they're just going to chase the hammer. But never mind, they decide, hey, Diablo's already way out of position, and he's already used his res, so he's going to be free. Johanna's sitting here trying to poke at the Immortal. I think that's going to pay for her life. Oh, this blessed shield going to keep her alive, and she's going to just walk away. But between the Monk and the Vala, are able to finally kill the Immortal. A little bit of, you know, the Lucio just walked straight up to him, was not respecting the Varian stun. The Varian actually went the High King's Quest, trying to see that his auto attacks, his piddly little auto attacks, can actually try to help with the race. I don't think that was needed. Even though they have 2 tanks, the Falstad Lucio is actually great against the Varian because his 3 attacks instantly give you 2 resets of your overpower. So I think Overpower was still the better choice here, even though they have two tanks. You're not really, you know, focusing on the tanks too much. Artanis is still in the back line, trying to clear lanes. So they don't have the swap potential here. Monk going in for the 7-sided. Another only hits one person that time. It was almost set up really well to hit four of them, but they were all able to get out of the range. You see the Purifier beam doing damage to the hammer, and he's just sitting there taking it, not caring in the world. Apoc hitting two members, but ends up dying. Soundbearer coming out a little bit too late to save him. If Artanis has another swap here, he could have gone for that hammer, but decided against it. So, Do It Right is just going to back off and get the mercs. They have control of the map. They have 13 on them. Diablo's still coming back, and they can play aggressive here. Lucio's probably going to rotate up here, try to get these top mercs. It's going to take them a long time to do that, so they have time. Granted, Falstad does fly. I would actually like Do It Right not to take these knights right now. They gain nothing from this at the moment. They just become a kill target until the next Immortal Shrine starts. The Immortal should start in the next 35 now. I'm gonna say 1430 is when the next Immortal is. Okay, good. I like it. They decided to not actually cap it. I'm glad. Knowing that if they did cap it, it would just get cleared right away, right before the Immortal, so there's really no point. Reversely, Admiral Ackbar did decide to cap theirs, and since there are five members... Oh, I was 30 seconds off, my bad. I didn't count the... I miscounted the waves. I thought I had four waves already. I like this. They're really understanding how to play the map correctly. Knowing to hold off on this a little bit just to force them out of position and have to deal with those mercs. See, because since Admiral Ackbar clicked it so quickly, they had already have it cleared. And now somebody from Ackbar is going to have to deal with those bottom ones. Uh-oh. Favorable position for Ackbar so far. They had the early start on it. But that hammer is actually going to play defense this time around. Getting in position to start getting the kills. They're looking, saying, hey, why don't we just get some kills first and then we'll attack the Immortal. Which is fair trade. Big Apoc followed up by the Hindolin's Blast, hitting two members, instantly killing them. And this should give them a easy Immortal. And that was the play they needed to come back into this game. Big Diablo charge, finishing off the Brightwing. And Lucio is just being a pain in the butt. Diablo should be able to flip him over. No, never mind. Just must not have had it on cooldown. And that was the engagement they needed. That little bit of hammer coming in to give him a little bit more damage. But that Apoc is actually hitting two members right in line for the Falstad. Falstad has been great on his positioning of where to do the Hunter's Blast. Really understanding the different funnel points. I must take up a new position. There's 5 seconds on Brightwing. Do It Right still has a second chance to come in and get a team kills. Brightwing does join the fight instantly. But they're going to have to do something fast. They're going to be looking for Artanis swaps. Or the Varian, if he pulls right into this... he does back away. Lucio followed up. Taunt comes out. Interrupts does, so they're not able to get enough. The big Hindolin's Blast hitting through four members, and that's going to be a quick reset. He's going to be looking to start positioning up top lane. We're going to be looking for that Falstad. Or just gets right here again. Diablo Joanna dying actually really quick. Purifier Beam comes out to scare him off. So like I said, Do It Right still had a chance to kill him. They got 16 right at the beginning of that fight, and they used that to their advantage. I would have really liked... I think Hindolin's Blast hit the... Yeah, they should have been able to do another one, but... Looking for the defense. Vala's actually going to be coming out here. They still do have Artanis. Varian's going to be coming back in a little bit. Looking for some big stuns. Swap on their hammer. Stuns. Stunlocked by the Immortal and... Or not the Immortal, but just the stunlock combinations. Another Hindolin's Blast. This Falstad's getting so much damage. He does pay for his life, but you know, I have to respect the gumbo to sit in those positions to hit those big Hindolin's Blast. And still not able to catch up to the Vala. The Vala auto attack damage is, you know, just keeping them far and ahead. The light of the crystal arch shines on. So far, three Immortals going to Do It Right. They're actually going to be looking for a party bush here. Let's see if anybody takes the bait. They do see the ward, so they're probably not... Uh-oh. Joanna, oh, so close. But now they just saw that ward go down, so they know that they are at bottom lane, plus they're clearing the lane. With a strong enough immortal, they decide to go for the keep that's already hurt. A pig, what that combo! With the Varian taunt and then the Artanis swap afterwards, keeping, make sure Lucio is out of position. What a combo from Do It Right. Hammer is still top lane, dealing with the top immortal. I would like them to continue pushing this keep. That pretty much gives them two keeps and double kill potentials. Artanis looking for another swap. No dice, but the follow up on the false dive with the taunt. No follow up on the taunt. There was enough stun from the Blessed Shield to interrupt the taunt. And both keeps do end up going down. A favorable position for Do It Right. They're looking like they can do no wrong here. Two keeps constantly going to have lane pressure. Catapults starting on both lanes. And now this is going to give them free reign to do anything they want on the map. So, once again, Vala, they're basically all rotating around, take all the different mercs, knowing that they don't have to push into this since they don't gain. Allow them to just pick it up themselves. And once again, they cap it. This time they had to cap it because since Do It Right has so much control of the map, they will not guarantee that they can hold that point. So both teams just going to rotate around. At this point, Do It Right is looking to get 20, looking to get any type of ganks. Diablo, I like it a lot. He's playing safe. He doesn't know where the team is. Any time that he goes past where their minions meet is a time when he can get ganked. We do look like we could get a rotation caught out over here. Oh, barely. Let's see the damage again. Baron is up above the damage DPS monk. But Diablo is actually beating them. Smartly, they do have to clear these knights. Make sure that they're not going to lose any keep during any of these team fights. So if Admiral Ackbar, if they have another team fight like that first round of Immortals, this Hammer, if this monk doesn't show, Hammer's way out of position. Okay, luckily that the rotation does not come out fast enough. Looks like they're looking for a gank. The monk does show, seeing somebody up here. They're being patient. They're looking for the kills that they want. Falstad. They're looking for that hammer, and he's staying up there. The hammer stun, one first stun goes down slow. Apoc hitting two members, interrupting the Brightwing. Monk having to use seven sided strike. Vala's getting way far out and ends up dying to the Joanna condemn. The hammer repositioned himself. The sound barrier a little late, didn't really actually deflect any damage. The idea of sound barrier is to stop right when the ultimates come down, so that would be right when Varian comes in, right when the Vala comes in. That's when you use sound barrier to interrupt any big damage. But they ended up winning that team fight, and if they get this immortal, honestly, Admiral Ackbar could be back in this game. Now that they're level 16, the graduating range is doing so much work to keep a hammer out of harm's way. And actually, this, I could see them taking this to core. Unless they get a really good flank on the hammer, there's not going to be anything that they're going to be able to do to stop hammer with graduating range. A full immortal in the late game stage, level 20 not quite reached yet. Winions are going towards the core, so Falstad is going to have to back and get that, but he has fly. Blessed Shield coming out. The big push on the Varian to go back into position, but he's able to just walk away. The Immortal actually saving the Artanis, pushing him in that direction. And this is where we're going to start getting scared. I mean, Do It Right had such a commanding lead over the whole game, but now with this late game Immortal and having the hammer still with graduating range, I mean. But luckily, Do It Right is killing this Immortal pretty quick without any type of, you know, fear. Without the Falstad, if Falstad had Gust and pushing him into this, I could actually push him into the hammer would be a bad idea, but they were actually able to clear this Immortal fairly quickly. It's only losing the one fort. Do It Right comes off with a lucky break since these two keeps already down, forcing one member to back. gave them a breathing room to be able to clear the immortal without any damage. Level 20 finally reached for Admiral Ackbar. The experience actually did even up almost completely near the same. So looking for a bush. Looking for a bush strat. No, don't show. Be patient. Be patient. They see the... I don't know. Do they even see this? Oh, the hammer. No! You messed it up. Aggressive looking. They're fighting outside of hammer range. Not something that they want to do. Apoc coming out, hitting one member because... Two members because of the Blessed Shield. There goes the sound barrier. That was a good sound barrier to stop any type of damage. Hinolin's Blast hitting three members, and only 40 seconds coming back on that. Trying to keep the monk in range of the hammer. Seven-sided coming out to do some damage, and the disengage of the Brightwing, the actual triple Emerald Wind, did a lot of damage to that Lucio, keeping him pressed against that wind. And that team fight, and nobody died. Wow. That was something. I mean, if Hammer didn't attack there, and the Vala might have walked upwards, then that probably could have been a dead Vala. You need to do a little bit of patience. I know you really, it's like, oh, they're in range. Maybe you had it on auto attack and when you needed it to be on, or you had it on hold when you needed to not be. So, a little unfortunate. That team fight could have gone more in their favor. But good on both teams for not actually losing anybody there. The great disengage by the Brightwing after all that damage that went out. Following up any of this damage, we do see Juggernaut looking for more of the burst. Repent before my wrath. Ooh, better position for Do It Right just because they have the faster race and they had everybody in position a lot sooner. Artanis getting stunned there at the last second. We'll be able to get healed by the Brightwing, no problem. Once again, I think this is favorable for the... They're just going to want to poke here. They know that they're going to be invaded upon. But the Hammer steps out a little bit too far. Not able to get the follow-up on the stun. We have all the ultimates up. Hammer is already disengaged. Another big Hinolin's Blast by the Falstead. But the great time of the Monk using the Storm Shield, that's the power of the two healers there. Look at... I mean, that was such a big Hinolin's Blast. And it's all pretty much completely healed up. And this is a full Immortal... pushing onto a no-keep lane. This is going to spell doom for him. The Hammer's going to be wanting to sit like pretty much right back here and setting up now so that he gets the graduating range before they actually engage. We're going to be looking for some big plays here. 30 seconds on Hinolin's Blasts. I actually thought that would have been shorter. I thought I saw him hit four people there. Hammer's in an aggressive position. It's going to be right next to the Immortal. That means the Immortal is going to stun him. Does already get swapped immediately by the stun sheet follow-up. And with that Hammer gone, another great Storm Shield to stop a lot of the damage. But with that Hammer gone, I don't think they have any chance of defending this. They'll eventually start batting around to see who to focus on. Artanis is just going to focus on the core, as the rest of the team should. Diablo does end up dying. And, I mean... they had the chance there. Admiral Ackbar had the chance. Hammer was just in a way too aggressive defense position. But congratulations to Do It Right. I feel like they definitely drafted for exactly what they wanted. The first pick, Vala, getting Artanis, getting and able to see to pick up the double heals to try to counter the Hammer push and the double tank push. Knowing that double heals will usually be able to sustain them longer. So I think that was a great choice on Do It Right, really understanding who's powerful on the map. But I also have to give props for Admiral Ackbar. I like their draft, honestly, just because I think the double tank Hammer could work. It's unfortunate that they didn't ban the people that could make them that lost them the race. There's too many situations where the Hammer was in a good position, the tanks were in a good position to try to delay, but there just wasn't enough pressure to stop the melee of Do It Right to actually stop doing damage to the Immortal. Like, it's just the two tanks and a Lucio. And with that, with the double heals and the Artanis tankiness, I mean, they were able to just, and they're out of range of Hammer while still attacking the Immortal. Then they're kind of like, okay, we'll just continue doing what we're doing. Late game, it did look scary once he got graduating range. But I think... with a little bit slightly different drafting, I think the double tank Hammer could work. But Yeah, I mean, I like the trial there. I like the attempt. I think it's a very cheeky play. So, congratulations to Do It Right. They did it right once again, getting them the win. So, anyways, guys, it's my last cast for the week. I have, right? I don't have a cast tomorrow. No, I'm good. So, yeah, pretty much. Yeah, so this game's gonna be uploaded up to my YouTube, to the descriptions down below. I actually have all of my chair league games that I've casted so far on the YouTube channel. Pretty much, I'm only gonna be using YouTube to store the chair league videos, just because Twitch only keeps them for 2 weeks. So if you ever want to go back and look at some of the other games that you've played, or some of the other games that I might have casted to try to get ideas from other teams, you can always check that out. But other than that, I enjoyed the games today. Both teams, I feel like they both came in with an idea of what they wanted to do, and it seems like they both got what they wanted. It just ended up that the comp that Do It Right wanted was just slightly better. Just won out. I was really hoping that they'd be able to push with that late game Immortal for Admiral Ackbar to get a really close game that would have made it really exciting. But congratulations to Do It Right. Hope to see you guys next week. I'll try to follow up as much as I can. So, anyways, hope you guys enjoyed it. Have a good time. I'll try to cast this weekend. Oh, not try to cast. I'll try to stream this weekend. Maybe some Hero League, maybe some Team League with my brother. Anyways, we'll see. See you guys around. Thanks. Bye.